Thank you, Leslie.
The nuclear future has become both more complex and more uncertain since the March 2011 Fukushima Daiichi accident. Some countries have announced that they are going to end their existing programs or stop their planned nuclear power programs. Many others have announced that they're going to move forward or even expand their civilian nuclear energy programs. Iran, for example, even announced that their new Russian-supplied reactor is the safest reactor in the entire world. To help us understand the nuclear future, we have put together a distinguished, diverse, and international panel of specialists. To give plenty of time for questions and comments from the audience, we've asked them to dispense with formal presentations, but rather to answer one question each. I'm going to briefly introduce them, ask one question to them, have them answer, and then we're going to open this discussion up. More fulsome bios are in your program, and so I'm just going to very briefly give a highlight for each. Harold Mueller is the director of the Frankfurt Peace Research Institute and professor of international relations at Frankfurt University. In 1995, 2000, 2005, and 2010, he participated as a member of the German delegation in the Nonproliferation Treaty Review Conference. Nuramli bin Muslim is Professor Emeritus in the Department of Science and Technology at the National University of Malaysia. He's the former chairman of the Malaysian Atomic Energy Licensing Board, former IAEA Deputy Director and head of the Department of Technical Assistance and Cooperation, and has served as the head of Malaysia's Nuclear Research Center. Olli Heininen is a senior fellow at the Belfer Center for Science and International Affairs at the Kennedy School at Harvard. Previously, Olli served for 27 years in the IAEA, the International Atomic Energy Agency, in Vienna, and for the last 5 years was the Deputy Director General of the IAEA and head of its Department of Safeguards, where he was responsible for many things, but including the efforts to try to shut down the AQ-CON nuclear proliferation network and leading the efforts to monitor and contain Iran's nuclear program. And last, Jayantha Dhanapala is president of the Pugwash Conference on Science and World Affairs. His previous posts include ambassador of Sri Lanka at the UN in Geneva, the Sri Lankan ambassador to the US, and the UN Undersecretary General for Disarmament, and in 1995, he was the president of the NPT Review Conference, in which the indefinite extension of the Nonproliferation Treaty was negotiated. So, Harold, let me start with you. The German government is one of the handful of governments around the world that announced after the Fukushima accident that it would phase out all domestic production of nuclear energy. Can you explain to us briefly why that decision was made? Is it likely to stick, in your judgment? And is the decision also influencing German nuclear export policy?